This episode I'll be looking at Masters of Doom by David Kushner. It focuses primarily on how two game programmers, John Carmack and John Romero, helped create the first-person shooter, id Software, gaming shareware, and much more besides. Structured like a novel, events are told using a third-person perspective, adding in a generous helping of direct quotes from the main players. Apparently Kushner conducted over 100 interviews over 6 years when putting this book together, and it shows. Getting all the interviews means nothing if they aren't weaved into a cohesive and enjoyable structure though, of course, but fortunately that's not a problem here. Yes, some of the storytelling is arguably a little basic, but the quality of the content almost always shines through. Told chronologically, as you'd expect, the book details the early days of PC gaming development, and how Romero and Carmack worked their way towards each other, and the subsequent titles they created together. Commander Keen, Wolfenstein 3D, Doom, Quake, the stories of how each game was created and distributed are present and correct, as well as details on how they performed in terms of sales. They generally did quite well. Learning about how shareware was used for PC gaming is far more interesting than you'd expect, but even if one chapter doesn't manage to grab your interest, I wouldn't worry. This isn't a book that sticks on one subject for long. It packs a lot into just over 300 pages. There's no skimping on how the games were actually programmed either. There's some jargon used at times that will mean very little to most people, and I include myself in that group. It's nice to have the details all the same, and what's most satisfying is seeing how Carmack and Romero somehow kept topping their previous title. What's more impressive, however, is that this is not a book that holds back on investigating the negative consequences of the duo's successes, with conflict constantly bubbling under the surface. There are subsequently passages that bristle with real tension and anger, such as when Carmack and Romero finally decide to go their separate ways. Carmack finally spoke. "We're still not happy with how everything's going, you know," he said. He reached for a piece of paper and handed it to Romero. "This is your resignation. You can sign it." Romero, despite all the warnings, all his plans, felt nothing but shock. "Wait," he said, "don't you mean a year ago that I wasn't working? Because these last 7 months I've been killing myself. I've been killing myself to make Quake." "No," Carmack said. "You're not doing your work. You're not living up to your responsibilities. You're hurting the project. You're hurting the company. You've been poisonous to the company, and your contribution has been negative over the past couple years." The amount of arguments and squabbles the book details is almost too much at times, in fact, with it often being very difficult to empathise with the two main protagonists.
This is certainly not a book that looks to paint Carmack and Romero as flawless geniuses.
At the start of the book, the former, as a 14-year-old, is described as having no empathy for other human beings, and although generally he seems a quiet and focused individual, it's hard to truly care if he succeeds or fails. Romero, on the other hand, seems hugely passionate about games, but several passages portray him as a genuinely heartless and troublesome presence.
Still, this arguably works to the book's advantage, not its detriment. Perfect characters aren't hugely interesting, after all.
Ultimately, I strongly recommend Masters of Doom, if you even have just a passing interest in the creation of one of the most influential games of all time, and a few other significant titles besides. Another plus point in the book's favour is that it's relatively easy to pick up, too. With the prices it goes for more than reasonable, you can grab a new copy for under £6, for example. If you'd prefer to have the Masters of Doom read to you, there's even an audiobook version performed by Will Wheaton. There's a free sample available on YouTube too.
Overall, this book's a bit like Doom actually, not hugely sophisticated, but fast-paced and almost always interesting.
Hey, thanks for watching. Please do give this video a thumbs up if you want to see more videos like this. Now you may recall I asked for your votes on which book I covered next when I reviewed Game Over by David Sheff in September, which you can watch by clicking the link above, but the poll for that actually ended up as a draw. No, I am not joking. As a result, I'll be looking at The Encyclopedia of Game Machines by Winnie Forster in the third episode of the Gaming Book Club, and that instalment will be out this time next week.
Until then, pleasant reading, and don't forget to pour yourself a cup of tea.
Today is tomorrow's history.